Hi everybody, welcome back to Tech Talk Tuesdays, or T-Cubed as we call it here at Blue Oak Energy. My name is Dan Noren, and today we'll be talking about load break disconnects and their use in a solar PV system. Now up here on the board we have a simplified diagram across the top of a solar PV system where we have solar arrays producing electricity, and that electricity is in a direct current form. We use an inverter to convert that to an alternating current form, which ultimately the customer needs over here on the other side. Now, the reason we need disconnect switches is to isolate components of the system for safety and for maintenance purposes. Here we're showing disconnect switches on the DC side and a disconnect switch on the AC side. Now, when we want to break these circuits while the system is operating, we call that load break, okay? The reason load break is significant is because current's actually flowing through that switch when you go to open it up. Now, why do we care? Well, here's what happens. When you open up that switch, you think the current stops immediately, and that's not the case. What actually happens is that current continues to flow even through the air gap in the form of an arc. Now, that arc puts out an enormous amount of heat, and that heat, if it's not extinguished quickly, can damage components, can damage material, can actually hurt personnel. So these load break disconnect switches have to be designed in such a way where that arc extinguishes quickly. Now, most commercially available disconnect switches are designed for AC current. And here's a typical wiring schematic of an AC disconnect, where you've got your three phases coming in here. Okay, each phase has a switch. All right, you have A, B, and C, plus a neutral, which is typically not switched. When you pull the handle on this disconnect, all three of these switches open up, and there's an arc formed between each of these switch legs and these contacts. Now, in an AC current situation, those arcs extinguish very quickly on their own. The reason for that is the cyclic behavior of alternating current. We're all familiar with the sine wave, right? The alternating current, it goes up, peaks at the top of a positive value, goes down, peaks at a low value, a negative value, and goes back up. It's cyclic. Well, one of the neat things about cyclic current is that it goes through a zero point as it goes from positive to negative, and it does that twice per cycle. Now, because the current actually goes to zero twice during an alternating current cycle, the arc extinguishes itself very quickly because that current actually goes to zero a couple of times. That's not the case with DC current. Now, a DC current, it's a constant value and it stays persistent. When you open up a DC disconnect switch, an arc forms and it wants to continue, and you have to open it with even a larger air gap to get it to extinguish. So how do we take what's typically a commercially available AC disconnect and use it in a DC disconnect application? Well, one way to do it is to take a single DC circuit and actually wire it through the switches, all three switches, in series, just like shown here. Okay, so when you actually pull the handle on this disconnect, all three switches again open all at the same time, but you have a single circuit going through here, and you basically increase that air gap that's required to dissipate that arc by a factor of three. Okay. This is how you can take a typical commercially available AC disconnect and use it in a DC disconnect application and it still maintain its UL listings and still be safe. Okay. So the key here though is every manufacturer makes a version of an AC disconnect that come in multiple poles of different numbers, and some of them can and can't be used in DC applications. The lesson to take away from this is that you need to read the manufacturer's installation instructions. Make sure if you want to use their disconnect in a DC application that they've already tested it for that application and you follow their installation procedure. Okay. All right, again, my name is Dan Noren from Blue Oak Energy, wishing you a sunny Tuesday.